Unity. We're going to explore the theme of unity tonight. Unity means coming together from separate to collective. It means teamwork, coordinating a group of people together to achieve a collective end, a collective achievement. We see unity when a team is really trained, integrated, working together, each individual utilizing his or her skills to the benefit of each of them and to the group as a whole. Teamwork is illustrated every day in working together, playing together, coordinating things together. It's interesting that an individual can be a super athlete or a super performer, but without a team, could be at effect and struggling to achieve. Michael Jordan, being an example of one of the greatest basketball players of all time, struggled in his first number of years with the Chicago Bulls because he didn't have a team. He was an all-star. Scored 40 or more points consistently, but could not win against other teams because he didn't have a team. Once he had a team, once the components of the team were working together, the Chicago Bulls were incredibly successful and won many championships. So that's just one example. There are many other examples of great teamwork. Launching a satellite together. Our scientists have to work together, planning. There's people who build the satellite. There's people who build the rocket. There are people who launch the rocket. And then those that track the rocket. All are necessary for that project to be a success. So, since I'm a native of the Salish and Kootenai tribes of Montana, I have some background in Native culture. And in American Indian tribal culture, there's a saying from the Lakota words, mitakwiasin, we are all related. What does it mean to say we are all related? The best that English can translate that is we are all related. Mitakwiasin also relates to the fact that we are part of a whole universe of energies, of creatures, of birds, animals, bugs, water, air, all part of what we share in a unity. So in a sense, we are in communion or in union with every other thing that is in existence in the universe. Now, in Hindu philosophy, there is the point of Vedantic oneness. Brahman is considered all being. We share in Brahman as a divine oneness. So we are all in part of this unity. We all can imagine it as a oneness that we share. And in fact, when you look at our yantra, the integral yoga yantra, it's in a round form. At the center is the divine oneness, which is within each and every one of us, which we share. On the external part of the yantra are the different paths, all to the same oneness, connected and achieving the same oneness even though they're at the same time diverse and different. This is the yoga teaching. We can understand this through the yantra. We can understand it when we reach out to others. And in our lotus, we have a temple dedicated to the oneness so that all paths can be celebrated, whether it be Judaism, Christianity. Yoga represents the ability to go deep into each of these traditions. So back to the Native American point. Chief Tecumseh in 1770 was an orator and a leader of the Eastern tribes. He went and traveled through all the different tribal areas, uniting the tribes to be able to protect their property as best they could, to be able to share and sustain themselves in a challenging times. Chief Tecumseh made his point when he traveled to each of these tribes. And I'm going to give you just an example. He would say, as a single person or a single tribe, we are not as strong. A single person or a single tribe can be broken. He would hold an arrow up and he would break it. A single person or a single unit is not as strong. Then he would hold up a bundle of arrows and say, together, we cannot be broken. We are united. We can sustain each other. We can support each other. That's an important point. By coming together, we strengthen what we are. We strengthen our ability to achieve together, and we support each other. Now, on the yoga path, our teacher, Sri Gurudev, Sri Swami Satchidananda, emphasized that the requirements for us to advance on the spiritual path would be to have a teacher, a guru, a teaching, and a sangha. So, why? We understand we have a guru. We understand having a teaching to follow. Why should we come together as a sangha? Well, on the path, there can be struggles. We can fall periodically. Our practice can sometimes be hard to follow. But by being together in a sangha, practicing together, we can inspire each other. We can raise each other up and carry each other along, and encourage each other to get back on the path, or to keep practicing, or to be brave in the face of having to chase the very difficult end result of liberation and self-realization. So Sangha is our unity. Sangha is the teachings brought together. Sangha is the yantra with all the diverse paths connecting at the center and supporting each other. Here at Yogaville, we have people who celebrate the nature religions. We have people who celebrate the Native American path, that celebrate the African spiritual path, those that celebrate Hinduism, Judaism, Buddhism. All are paths that allow us to experience this unity. And from that position, we can share. One of the most beautiful aspects of Yogaville and Integral Yoga is we can learn about the other paths and understand them from this unified position that we are all striving for happiness, for freedom, and the ultimate spiritual aim of unity. So this is part of unity on the spiritual path. And we've seen how unity, even in working together and in sports, is important. So I want to get back to the truth is one, paths are many point. We had a project here at Yogaville, which was to keep the environment clean. We had to contend with a pipeline that was going to be placed in our neighborhood. It was going to be placed where the pipeline and its methane and its dangerous volatile fuel could potentially spill or explode or endanger our community. Even the compressor station was placed in the routing 5 miles away in the neighborhood of our friends at Union Hill Baptist Church. So we joined with Union Hill Baptist Church. We became friends with these wonderful African-American folks and a few other non-African-American people in that same area. And we worked together, researched together, and determined that this would be a bad situation for our health and for the future of our environment. So we marched together. We wrote letters to the state and federal government together. We joined together in this effort in a way that we might never have been joined together if we just saw each other as different faiths. But the beauty of this is that we were able to visit our friends at the church at Union Hill and the church at Union Grove, both in the same area. And we sang gospel music. We prayed Christian prayers. We chanted Sanskrit prayers in that church with Krishnadas, a master kirtanist, who chanted Sanskrit. We all applauded and sang, and then he chanted and sang gospel, which we all stood up and clapped our hands and sang. So we unified. We came together on a very difficult project with a strong corporate presence wanting to put this pipeline in, an $8.5 billion project. We had very little to start with, no traction with the government, no traction even with the media. But we started by unifying, then researching together, and then joining together to do everything we could, including marching across the Lee Bridge together into Richmond to demonstrate that we were appealing to the public and everyone to take into account our needs as a people here on the planet wanting to keep the environment clean and our health pure. Ultimately, after 6 years and many court battles and much letter writing and a lot of singing and chanting, we were able to outlast the huge corporation, and they decided to cancel this pipeline. Amazing historical achievement done with American Indian people, Black African-American community members, Yogaville people of all types and creeds, joining together with much greater power than we would have ever had by ourselves. This was an amazing achievement. Even beyond that, we were able to chant and pray in a Baptist church, which I may never have visited except with our friends on this project together. We experienced prayer and coming together in the Baptist church. Likewise, the Union Hill community came to our satsang hall. We had gospel music. We stood and chanted and prayed. And we brought this unity here and shared it here at Yogaville. My dear friend, Pastor Paul Wilson, who was a very important leader for the Union Hill community, he came and stayed here for a while, and he went to our Lotus Temple. Now, when he was approaching the temple, he said, well, I'll go into this temple, never having been to a temple before, trained in the Baptist way and the Baptist religion. And he told me, he said, I was determined, I'm going to pray Baptist prayers at the Lotus. And so he went in and he sat down And he prayed his prayers. And in just a moment, he felt the peace there in the lotus. And his heart opened more. And he kept praying. And the peace kept resounding with him. And after a while, he came out. And he came up to me and put his arm around me. And he said, "Jeeva, I've got a little bit of a problem." And I said, "What's that, Pastor Paul?" He said, "While I was in the temple, I experienced the grace of God descend upon me." Now, I never thought that was possible outside of my church. But here, I now have experienced it in a wider way. And my mind is now open to this. And I'm going to have to open up my heart to this reality. And he is a wonderful friend. And to this day, he points out that at Yogaville, this is a sacred ground that people can experience the beauty and peace of God. And likewise, I can say that my experience at Union Hill was very much the same. We came together there with environmental groups. We came together there with the community members. We came together there as yogis. And we celebrated our oneness and our unity in a way that couldn't be experienced without us coming together as one. As our teacher and our guru has encouraged us, we have come together in the years we have studied with him in different ways. We have united at institutes where people could live in a common house, practice the yogic lifestyle, the yogic diet, the integral yoga practices, keeping our minds peaceful, supporting each other when we have a problem, helping each other along the path. And Yogaville came about as part of that unification, as a place where all of integral yoga or anyone can choose to come to taste a little bit of this union. They can, again, come together to have the yogic diet. We have a wonderful farm that produces food, brings it to our kitchen. They prepare it in a wonderful, nutritious way and provide it to our table. What a wonderful, healthy lifestyle that we share. Likewise, we have temples and sacred spots here where we share our prayers, each in our own way. Often when I would give a tour of Yogaville, I would go to Kailash, which is on an overlook where we can look out over the Lotus Shrine. We can look out over the Blue Ridge Mountains. We can see nature, the forest, the trees, the flowers. And I would say to my tour group, "To me, this is my altar. This is God. Present to me," and all these, as our guru would say, names and forms. But within that, it is the common oneness that is displayed that we can see right in front of us. And that's a very beautiful aspect that I can share because I look at nature in that way. So we can come together. We can support each other in this union, whether it's working together as a good team, listening to each other carefully, supporting each other when we need to, developing that team spirit so we're really a top-notch, excellent, effective team, working together, listening to each other, responding, getting better in coordination. All of these aspects are part of unity. And then there's the highest aspect, which is that in reality, we are all sharing in this oneness of existence. And that can be experienced too, if we go within, if we follow our own unique paths, whether it be prayer, singing, chanting, service, all of those paths lead ultimately to the same oneness. So I ask you today to think of that oneness, particularly when you feel you're a little brittle, you're a little weak, you're not feeling connected, you're feeling alone maybe, or you've been in a pandemic at home for a long, long time. So think of that. Meditate on the oneness that we do share. We can reconnect with each other. We can reach out and help someone. There is a story about a Zen master who was asked by a disciple who was depressed, not achieving much in his meditation. He said, "Master, I keep trying, but I'm discouraged. I just feel alone and very discouraged." And the master said, "Well, there's a way to mitigate that. All you need to do is go out and find someone who is discouraged, someone who is in the same situation you are, and go to them and offer them encouragement. Your discouragement will disappear, and you will be there for that person." This is how we come into union. This is the unity beyond all differences. And this is what we bring to each other when we share and become unified. So I just want to wish you blessed peace during these times and end with a brief prayer and chant that we would have peace within us and offer it to all others. Om Shanti, Om Shanti, Om Shanti, Om. Om Shanti, Om Shanti. Om Shanti, Om. Om Shanti, Om. Om Shanti. Thank you so much.